Thank you all for coming out today. We really need the community's support and the news media's assistance in putting out this information. We have a missing child, a four-year-old child. Her name's Sequoia Samuels. She's a female black, 4 years old, 3 feet tall, 30 pounds. She was last seen wearing a light blue shirt with some black pants with multicolored hearts on the pants. She was last seen in the area of 264 Caldwell. She possibly was walking on the north side of the street, which is right here close to Caldwell and North 7th. We want to try to get this information out to the public and the community within to start looking in their backyards, checking around their homes, and asking about other neighbors to wake up and start searching their areas as well. Is there any questions? At this time, she's just a missing child. She is in danger because she's a four-year-old child that's out by herself, and she will, it's hot. That's a concern for us. But we do have partners from the Shelby County Sheriff's Department, as well as the Memphis Police Department has multiple people on the ground looking for her. So yes, it is a danger on her.
When will it become an Amber Alert?
So it's not an Amber Alert because she's just a missing child. We do have a city watch out on her, which has information and broadcast throughout the radio stations and news media. The Amber Alert becomes when there's a kidnapping. This is not a kidnapping.
Can you elaborate on the feeding tube on the left side of her stomach?
So she has special needs that she should be monitored on, and that also puts her in risk.
It's a gastrointestinal tube. We don't know much more about it, but there is a medical concern with her.
Was she out by herself when she was walking?
Yes.
She was last seen
at 264 Caldwell in the area. In the area. No, that's a little bit away from the home, east of the home.
Have we heard from the parents at all?
Yes. So at around 0306 is the last time she was seen. On camera, and the parents did call her in this morning at around 6:37 this morning, 6:37 a.m. She was called in, so she apparently got out the home some kind of way during the morning hours.
Do you know why they called 3 hours later? Is this something that she's done before?
We have no information on whether she's done this before.
Just to clarify, she left around
3:06
a.m. on camera.
She was last seen on camera at 3:06 a.m.
Leaving
away from the home. Away from the home.
So your efforts right now, guys, are investigating the area. Can you just explain
some of your efforts? So we're doing a ground search, a door-to-door ground search. We asked the community, if we do knock on your door, please answer and be able to help us out in looking through your yard. We're also doing an aerial search. We have canines, bloodhounds out that can actually assist with the search as well. There's other search teams that we have in with that we've called in from specialized units that we have. We have investigators out on ground that we pull from out of investigative units to be part of the search. And like I said, we're also working with the Shelby County Sheriff's Department and their search and rescue team. They're going to bring out some specialized tools as well to assist us. It is. It is. It's a huge concern. The child doesn't have water, food, and those things, and being in a cool place. So if the community sees the child, we ask that you please, please contact the Memphis Police Department, 911. 911, if you see this child, please, if you can, just hold her where she is, and we'll come to her. We'll come to you. So it's expanding wide. There's been hours between the time. So right now we're focusing on a small area, but it's expanding as we go because she's a small child, 4 years old. 4 years old by herself, so.
How many units do you have mobilized?
Multiple at this time.
How are the parents doing? Are they helping with the search or?
Yes, the parent is helping with the search.
Hourly.
you'll be able to get with PIO, and we'll advise when the next update will happen. That's it. Okay, I'm Deputy Chief Paul Wright. I'm with the Investigative Service Unit, and that controls, that's a part of missing person.
Okay.